One of the things that people ask me all the time is, haven't we explored everything? You know, haven't we mapped everything? Haven't we been everywhere at this point? And of course, the answer is no.
Take the Amazon rainforest, for example. Over 1 billion acres and huge areas of it have not been explored in modern times. For example, this area called Vale do Javari in Brazil. There are over 12 uncontacted tribes living there today.
Yeah, and I think a lot of people have the tendency to just think of land. I mean, I always think of the ocean. I mean, it's huge. We've just started exploring the depths of it. We're finding new species living there all the time. So, you know, who's to say what else we might find?
And in fact, the topic of unexplored places is really at the heart of today's case. So a few weeks ago, I received a message from a guy named Mark Wenner. Now, Mark is a caving expert. He has explored caves all over the world. He lectures around the world on caves and cave safety. And in particular, he has spent thousands of hours in a place called Mammoth Cave. So you may know Mammoth Cave. This is in Kentucky. It is actually the longest cave system in the world. Now, Mark knows his stuff. This guy is a real deal expert, which is why I was so surprised to hear about his team's recent experience down in the cave. Check this out.
We've been mapping Mammoth Cave for 14 years. Initially, the first couple trips were pretty standard operation. The second or third trip, though, we experienced some things that were very unexplainable.
Measuring 420 miles and counting, the Mammoth Cave in central Kentucky was inhabited by Native Americans starting about 4,000 years ago. They used the caves as shelter and for burial rituals, a spiritual realm where they could commune with the dead. Then, about 2,000 years ago, they suddenly abandoned the caves. Some descendants say their ancestors were driven away by ancient spirits deep within the darkness. A more conventional explanation is that changes in climate drove game animals away, and the people followed the food. Whatever the reasons for their abrupt departure, Mammoth Cave remains a place of mystery. In the past few centuries, there have been numerous deaths and disappearances, and many claims of paranormal activity. In the deepest, uncharted parts of the cave, people have reported feeling like they were stalked and even touched by a menacing, shadowy figure. While many chalk up such reports to colorful legend and lore, others, including cave experts like Mark, disagree, having experienced this terrifying presence firsthand.
So the four of us were walking down the passage, and out of the shadows comes this presence. It's the only way that I can explain it. It was as real as the guys standing next to me. In fact, so much so that I had to turn to see if one of those guys had walked behind me. So I said, "You guys feel that person that just entered our party?" And Matt, who was on the end, said, "Absolutely."
Really strange stuff. Now, I've spent a lot of time in caves over the years, and look, they are extremely strange, mysterious worlds. I mean, this is quite literally the underworld.
Wow, it is spectacular in here.
But this is something I've never experienced.
No, this is next level. I mean, I definitely have heard of Mammoth Cave before. A lot of people have reported shadow figures, strange sounds, and like obviously even Mark and his team experienced some sort of presence down there. So all of that stuff combined, I don't think you can dismiss it. To me, that's very much worth investigating.
Phil, what do you think?
Caves are the exact type of place you'd expect a story like this to kind of come alive.
Right.
They are incredibly dark. They are disorienting. And throughout history, people all over the world have always looked at them as mystical or a portal to the other side. So to me, it's no surprise that people would think a deep, dark cave is haunted or has something living in it. But it does give me pause when a caving expert like Mark has a story like that.
Right. This is a really credible guy. And part of a team of scientists, right? This isn't just one person having an experience. So the mission is simple. What's going on in Mammoth Cave that has these scientists so spooked? Or is nothing going on? Is it nothing more than campfire stories and folklore? They're here to meet with Mark Wenner's colleague, Dr. Pat Cambyses.
Hi.
It's good to meet you.
Good to meet you.
Pat teaches Geographic Information System Mapping, or GIS, at Western Kentucky University. She also runs Kentucky's Cave Research Foundation and has personally explored and mapped caves all over the world.
Welcome to Mammoth Cave, longest cave in the world. It is over 400 miles long. But you understand that's not like 400 miles in a straight line,
yeah.
Right? It's like 400 miles stacked on like five levels.
Geologists estimate that the origins of the cave system date back 15 million years to when the Green River carved its way through a thick cap of sandstone below, exposing a 600-foot layer of soft limestone. Over the course of the next 10 million years, flowing water hollowed out the stone, creating a labyrinth of stacked subterranean passages that are still being mapped to this day.
Let's go see some cave.
All right, thanks.
Whoa.
Wow.
So what was the cave like before all the modern construction?
Well, it was a lot more rugged than what you see now. The original Native Americans were the explorers. You had to be really ballsy to come in here with cane torches and barefoot. There's no light, so you have to figure that they had to overcome a lot just to come in here.
The caves were occupied by ancestors of the Cherokee tribe. They mined the upper three levels of the cave system, seeking minerals such as gypsum and selenite, which were used for trade, rituals, and even medicine.
And then after about 2,000 years ago, there isn't a lot of evidence of their activity.
So it's like they completely disappeared from here.
We don't know. So there's a lot of mystery. I mean, there's a lot of things that we know, but there's a lot of things that we don't know.
Did they ever use the cave for burials at all?
There have been some mummies found in here, but they didn't mummify them. It's because of the atmosphere of the cave.
The consistent temperature and humidity, as well as the salt found in the soil, means that Mammoth Cave is the perfect environment for mummifying a body. Although the exact number of people who have died in Mammoth Cave is unknown, caving experts are certain the number of deaths is vastly underreported. The bodies of most people who disappear in and around the caves are never found.
What are your thoughts on paranormal activity in the cave?
Well, first, you know, I am a scientist. Mm-hmm. However, I like to keep an open mind. And so I wouldn't totally discount it. I mean, you know.
You're my favorite kind of scientist.
I'm right
Do you
here.
Need a job? I'm just kidding.
We've heard reports of people seeing things in here, hearing things in here,
chanting, or even being pushed.
Yeah.
Especially when they go into unmapped sections of the cave.
So what are your thoughts on that?
You know, a lot of it could be psychological. If you stay in the cave long enough, you start to hear things and you start to see things.
Going cave crazy.
Yeah. Because you're sensory deprived. Your mind starts to play tricks on you. And so maybe you could go a little cave crazy.
It's pretty terrifying, actually.
Sensory deprivation can cause anxiety and even hallucinations in as little as 15 minutes. The brain seeks out sensory patterns, and when none exist, it creates its own.
Whoa.
Have you had any experiences while down here that you can't really explain?
I actually have. I was on a trip where we were down there, and we were just kind of sitting around on this flat rock, and it just kind of got really weird. Like, there was some sort of like, is there somebody here? You know, everybody got that feeling. We got a little bit spooked. And then we started hearing like rock fall, and we're like, oh, you know, because all of us are here.
Yeah.
The feeling was too strong, and we're like, okay, we're out of here.
That, wow. So bad enough we're to scare you out.
Oh, yeah, we left.
In an encounter similar to Mark's, Pat said she too sensed a dark shadow and felt the presence of some type of entity. Whatever is down here seems to have scared this extremely experienced caver enough that she and her team wanted to get out immediately.